President, our fraternal leaders on the dais, and comrade delegates. The resolution has been circulated. The resolution is restoration of people's and workers' rights in Jammu and Kashmir. The resolution has 5 points. The first point that we are raising in the resolution is that on 5th August 2019, the Government of India, by a governmental order, abrogated Article 35A of the Constitution of India. General impression is that Parliament has abrogated 370 and 35A. It is not so. On 5th August, precisely on 5th August, by GO, a government's order, 370 was abrogated, Article 370 as well as Article 35A. Next day, 5th and 6th together, August, they have introduced a bill in the Parliament. That's the second point, a bill in the Parliament. By that bill, reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir Act was passed within 2 days in the House. Reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir. By reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir, it is not reorganization, dismantling of Jammu and Kashmir. For the first time in independent India, a state has been dismantled and emerging out two separate entities, union territories. And both the union territories are directly under the control of the central government. So character of Jammu and Kashmir has changed from state to union territories and dividing it by Reorganization Act for the first time in independent India. This is the first assault on the Constitution of India. We have not, many of us have not understood this. This is the first assault on the Constitution of India. It is the assault on the federal character of our country. And this is moving towards the unitary organization, unitary country. And this is precisely the basis of Hindu Rashtra. The foundation of Hindu Rashtra must be unitary. And therefore, there has to be attack on the federalism. And therefore, by an act of the Parliament, on 5th and 6th August, Jammu and Kashmir has been dismantled into two union territories. In the Schedule 1 of the Constitution of India, the states number 15th, where Jammu and Kashmir featured, has been abolished. In Schedule 1 of the Constitution, there were 28 states. By this act, now we have 27 states. The experiment which they have done in Jammu Kashmir can be repeated in any state. Central government has usurped the power to change a state to union territories directly under the state government. They have shown they have done it in Jammu and Kashmir. It's the precursor of CAA. First step was move towards unitary country. The second stage was now Citizenship Act is all these are coming, so are moving a Hindu Rashtra. Combined together, we're moving towards a Hindu Rashtra. That's the point we are raising in this resolution, point number two. Point number three that we have said, during the entire period, the entire democratic process, the trade union rights, people's rights have been suppressed. No other state suffered this much. We must remember Jammu and Kashmir is a state of India. That state, their people, citizens, Indian citizens' rights in the state of Jammu Kashmir has been suppressed, brutally suppressed by the central government. As if Jammu and Kashmir is a occupied territory by military. That is the character they are changing. It's a siege under siege. Jammu and Kashmir under siege. That is they are trying to change in Jammu and Kashmir. They are moving. Fourth point we are raising, that situation still continues in different form. Suppression of trade union rights, suppression of democratic rights, this continues. The fifth point therefore we are raising is, the first point first is the restoration of normalcy and democratic rights and trade union rights of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. Restore the rights, let the political process start. And through the political process, restoration of the state will take place. But first, restoration of their trade union, people's liberties, people's rights, trade union rights be restored immediately. And after restoration of these rights, let the people fight politically, and then let the political process start. And through the political process, restoration of federalism and a state can emerge out in Jammu and Kashmir. That is the position. Therefore, I once again read the resolution. The 16th Conference of the Central Indian Trade Union, CITU, being held in Chennai on 23rd to 27th January 2020, notes with grave concern that bypassing the parliament, the people of Jammu and Kashmir and their legislative assembly, BJP Modi government through government's order ended the special provision under Article 370 and Article 35A of the Constitution of India. And in just 2 days, on 5th and 6th of August 2019, the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019 was passed by both houses of the parliament, dissolving the state, dismantling it into two separate entities, and bringing both under the direct control of the central government as union territories. For the first time in independent India, a state under Schedule 1 in the Constitution has been dissolved. This is a serious assault on the federal character of the Constitution of India moving towards a unitary India. Prior to and since then, entire valley remains locked down, commerce, business, education institutions closed, all movements on roads blocked, telecommunications snapped, all civil liberties curbed, state leaders and opposition, national and regional parties remained under house arrest. Leaders of national political parties were detained in Srinagar airport as if the state is under siege. The state situation still continues unlawfully, curbing the people's civil rights, democratic movement, including the trade union rights. Their assembly and demonstration, etc., are being curbed. Trade union rights are being trampled with the while the workers, including migrant workers, are being subjected to severe exploitation and repression. The 16th Conference CITU demands immediate restoration of normalcy and erstwhile territory of Jammu and Kashmir, allowing the democratic movement, inclusive the trade union movement, and restoration of civil liberties and trade union rights. The 16th Conference CITU calls upon the working class of India to stand in solidarity with the suffering workers and the people of Jammu and Kashmir, and resort to united democratic movement to restore the normalcy and rights, including trade union rights in Jammu and Kashmir. I recommend this for your approval and adoption.